I'm going to show you how to set up and use the best free firewall for Windows. It's called Portmaster. You can download it for free from Portmaster's website, from Safing, or you can also download it from GitHub. I will drop the links to download it in the description below. When you go through and get it set up, this is the screen you're going to be greeted with. This is your main screen. I'll just go through this here real quick. This is basically similar to Wireshark and that you'll see all of the connections that are going on with your computer. Now there's other tools that I really like. Simple Wall's a good one, but it doesn't have all of this stuff available on it. There's other stuff like Windows Firewall certainly doesn't have any of this stuff, but it's nice being able to see all of the incoming and outgoing connections on your computer. So we'll just click on one of these here, for example, this LAN multicast outgoing. So it'll show you a whole bunch of data about it. We'll click this one, the Chromium Next DNS will tell you blocked rogue connection to DNS resolver. And then from here you can do things like allow domain, change the app setting. You can also go to process details and see more details about it. There's not really any need to get too hung up on this. The one thing you want to pay attention to is if you're trying to go to a website and it's not working, or you're trying to open an app and it's not working, and you have this software enabled, what you'll want to do is open up this firewall and take a look and see if something got blocked. Because typically if something's not working and it used to work before you use this, it's probably getting blocked for some reason by Portmaster. And on some of these connections here that are blocked, I probably won't be able to see this. Some of them you'll see the reason that it was blocked is because it used a filter list, and we'll get to those here in just a minute. So that's the main page. The next one that you can go to here, this is your apps page. So with another great thing about Portmaster is it blocks according to IP addresses, domain names, and apps. So you have control of all three, whereas with something like Simple Wall, you only get to block according to IP addresses and apps. So for example, let's open up Microsoft Edge. Now in here you can see all of the specific connections, so you can come in here and block a specific connection. You could block the entire app. The other thing that you can do is you can also turn on SPN. Now this is a free open source program. I'll just go through SPN here real quick. It stands for the Safing Private Network. It's similar to Tor in that it has a bunch of nodes. Now I've never used it. I'm not getting sponsored by Safing to make this video, so I can't tell you how good or bad or indifferent I am to using the SPN. From what I've read on the technical documents, technical details, sounds like it's probably pretty good. Functions very similar to Tor. Again, I haven't used it, but one of the nice things is that you could enable it per app. So on VPNs, you can do something called split tunneling. Now with split tunneling, you could have some of your regular connections go through, or some of your connections go through your regular internet, and then some use the VPN. So in a way, this is kind of like split tunneling in that you could have some of your apps in your computer use your normal IP address from your ISP, and then some of them could be routed through here. Now, this next button here is just for the SPN. It goes through a little more detail. You can read the full documentation on their website for SPN. You can go into the specific details. Again, it looks pretty nifty. I just haven't really used it. I don't really have a need to use it. But that is how they make their money, so they can keep the app going, keep the development going and all that. Now, we'll go to global settings. There's a couple things you really want to pay attention to when you're setting this stuff up. One thing that I absolutely love about this program is you can set DNS, you can set encrypted DNS for your entire operating system, not just through your browser. So I made a previous video on Firefox talking about locking it down, and there was a section Firefox where you can set a specific encrypted DNS provider. So you could use like NextDNS, Cloudflare, Quad9, whatever you want to use. Now in here, there's quick settings. Actually, let me just go ahead and move my camera here. Now, and here you have quick settings. So you can select Cloudflare, you can do Quad9 AdGuard. You can also add your own custom in here, so you could use DNS0, I believe, which is what the EU citizen, it was set up for EU citizens. We'll get into that more in a second. So you can set your encrypted DNS. Now, something to keep in mind, if you do set this, let me just open up Brave browser here, for instance. You'll have this issue with your browser. So just make sure that if you use encrypted DNS through Portmaster, go to your security settings for your browser. If you are using secure DNS already, you have to turn this off in order for the websites that you try to go to load. So if you have secure DNS on through here, through your browser, and you have secure DNS on through Portmaster, if you go and try to load up a website, you're gonna get this error right here. Now, there may be some cases where it will actually continue to load through, but if you're having this issue, what you need to do is turn off your secure DNS through your browser. And you can go run checks to make sure that encrypted DNS is still enabled. So if I were to go and run a test, I would be able to see that Quad9 is enabled and that it is routing through there. So let me just refresh this now that I've turned that off. Now if I refresh this, take a second, the website will load. Now while we're on the topic of DNS, I wanted to load up this article. I will drop a link to it down in the description. This article was posted about 2 weeks ago. This was a really good read. This was a security researcher that tests a whole bunch of malicious domains to see which of the DNS providers would block the malicious domains. So while we're on the topic of talking about using a secure DNS provider, one of the great things about these and having this enabled at the operating system level is you can block a whole bunch of garbage at the operating system level instead of just your browser. Now again, I'll drop a link. One of the things you can look at on here, you can see what these different ones block. So for default on, I believe a lot of browsers and also on here, is the default is Cloudflare. Now you can see out of the blocked malicious domain percentage here, Cloudflare for families here was only about 13%. So that's a pretty garbage block rate. Now there could be some legitimate websites that get blocked if you try and use something like DNS0, but this is typically why you want to do a little bit of research and figure out what's gonna work best for you. Quad9 is an excellent secure DNS provider. You could also use DNS0.eu if you're in the European Union. All of their servers are located in the EU. I don't see any reason. If you're a US citizen, for example, I don't see any reason that you couldn't use them, but you're probably gonna have some issues with latency. Now, one of the services that they did not test was NextDNS, and they said the reason for that was in order to get the block lists and all that is you have to sign up for an account, and they just wanted to test things that you could just type right in your browser without having to set up an account or anything like that. Now, NextDNS, the founders of NextDNS started DNS0.eu. So I think it's fairly safe to say that the block rate of NextDNS would probably be somewhat similar to DNS0.eu. So if you want to use Quad9, NextDNS, or DNS0.eu, you're going to be in pretty good shape. It's going to block a lot of garbage by default just from trying to go to stuff on the web. This is that layered approach where as you set up things like your firewall, your antivirus, the Windows Defender stuff that I talked about in a previous video, you set up secure DNS, you will have a very, very secure system when you do a little bit of upfront work. Now, one other thing that I'm gonna talk about this, there's some other settings here. You can click info. I'm not gonna get into it because the video is gonna go on really long. We're already at 10 minutes right now. I could go on a long time about all this other stuff, but by default, this all works really well. By default, Portmaster does block incoming connections. Typically, it's a good idea to just leave it at that because of privacy and security issues of just allowing them. The one other thing, so filter lists. So I was talking earlier about here from the main page, you'll see a blocked connection and sometimes it will show a filter list. So you might see a connection get blocked, and then when you click on that to get more details, it might say it was blocked because you had, let's say, the Addaway ads list filter checked. So you have all of these services on here that are set to block. These are all of the default lists. You can also add other stuff. So you can add deception, phishing, fraud, NSFW. So if you were to go and then type these into a browser and try to open them up, for example, NSFW, what it should do is just go ahead and block that from even being able to load. Now you will notice there may be some websites that are completely legitimate that won't load, or they will only partially load and you won't notice everything load. Again, if you notice that, you're gonna have to be able to go into Portmaster, open up your connections page, and check and see if there was a specific IP that got blocked that's only blocking part of the website. So some of it will load and some of it won't. I've noticed this issue on Twitter, where on Twitter I was trying to load, the website load would load normally, but there was a couple sections that wouldn't finish loading. And so I had to go into Portmaster and allow some specific connections. But as long as you're willing to take just a little bit of time to set this stuff up and kind of get used to it, this is a super, super good firewall. I've tested a ton of firewalls for Windows, and of all of the, this by far so far is my favorite free firewall for Windows. Blows the competition out of the water. Like I said, I love stuff like SimpleWall, but the amount of customizability and the amount of control that you have with this is just amazing. And by the way, again, like I said, I'm not being sponsored by Safing. This is a free program. I've never used the SPN. Not that I'd be opposed to a sponsorship, but this is just a really good program. This is a great way to secure your system. So I mentioned in the previous video about Windows Defender, Windows Firewall is very lackluster. So if you're going to use Windows Defender, what I really recommend is that you have something like this, because this will give you a whole lot more security, and having a good firewall is essential. You can't just rely on an antivirus. You must have a good firewall. Now, with all that being said, that's gonna wrap the video up. If you wanna see any more specific topics on any sort of computer security, cybersecurity, network security, antivirus, firewall, anything like that, make sure you go ahead and drop a comment down below. Let me know, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next video.